Hey, how's it going, Yankees fans? It is Felix from NYNews.com. Hola, ¿cómo estás? Hey, Yankees fans, the Yankees just signed Neil Walker. They were going to sign him before the Drury trade, but I guess they stayed in communication. Neil Walker wanted to play for New York. If you ask me, Torres is not having a good spring. It's a good pickup. It's obviously an upgrade from Danny Espinosa. Neil Walker is solid. Like I said, one word to describe Neil Walker: solid. Good pickup. Don't know the numbers yet. Obviously, it's for 1 year, but I still don't know for how much. So, Yankees fans, what does this mean? This means that Torres is going to see more time in the minor leagues, obviously, coming off of Tommy John surgery. I guess he wasn't playing at full capacity. You know, when you get an injury for the first time, it's kind of hard to, let's say, hyperextend that injury. You know, you're not doing it. But it just feels weird. I guess that's what Torres is feeling right now. And as I say this, now that I see it, so the Yankees signed former Pirate, former Met, Neil Walker for 1 year, $5 million. Like I said, solid pickup. Torres wasn't doing that well. Obviously, an upgrade from Danny Espinosa. Neil Walker is your everyday starting second baseman. Now, is Andujar going to start the season at third base? Is he going to catch fire yet again? He's obviously hitting still. But let's say if he goes absolutely beast mode, will he win the job at third base? He kind of settled down. He's kind of cooling off. But we don't see Drury taking off that much as Andujar did. So let's see. Is Andujar still in play for third base? Let's see. Drury has been kind of solid in my opinion. He kind of reminds me of a Japanese hitter, but like I said, if you're not going to keep Andujar up here, it's really no use, folks, developing players and not giving them a shot. The Yankees supposedly were going with a youth movement, developing their players, giving them a shot. Hey, Drury's still young, but let's say in Andujar, obviously Torres is going to start the season at AAA. I mean, give Andujar a shot. If he flops, let's say in 2 weeks, in a 2 week span, you just give that spot a Drury. Obviously, Drury's going to be on your ball club as a super utility player, or maybe shuffling Andujar and Drury at third base. And Alex Cobb, it looks like the Orioles are about to sign him now. I don't know why they didn't before. Obviously, Cobb is a steal. Obviously, all these ball clubs are not spending. I mean, these contracts are ridiculous when you look at it. $6 million for Moustakas, you're going to tell me these organizations don't have more than that. I mean, it's pretty stupid what's happening right now that players going into free agency are not getting the money that they deserve. Obviously, they're filling up these seats. Obviously, they're legit names. They helped organizations put fans into seats. And really, if you think about it, if you add all these fans up, 6 million, it doesn't equal 6 million to, let's say, a Mike Moustakas. So those contracts are very ridiculous, and I could see a strike happening in a few years. So, folks, as I am saying this, it has been reported that the Yankees are not interested in bringing Alex Cobb for 1 year. It looks like the caller that left me a voicemail was pretty accurate that they're waiting to sign or trade for other pitchers, trade for, let's say, an Archer or Fulmer. So that voicemail was pretty accurate. So it says here that the Yankees are not interested in Alex Cobb for a year. Sources, it says that while the Bombers could add Cobb and still stay under the $197 million luxury tax threshold, they aren't interested in sacrificing draft picks in order to sign him. The 30-year-old righty also has an injury history, having undergone Tommy John surgery in 2016, though he did manage to go 12-10 with a 3.66 ERA last season with Tampa. So there you have it, folks. Alex Cobb is not on the Yankees' radar. That voicemail was pretty accurate. Like I said, folks, leave me a voicemail at 646-849-0617. That's 646-849-0617. I got a whole bunch of voicemails, but they weren't lengthy. A few seconds here and there. People are sending me text messages with their insights, continue to do that. Let's continue the dialogue. So, Yankees fans, It looks like the Yankees had their thoughts on trading for a starting pitcher. I don't know if it happens now. It will definitely happen come trade deadline. The Yankees are just absolutely stacked, folks. So look for a Fulmer or Chris Archer to become a Yankee. Alex Cobb will not be a New York Yankee. It looks like he's going to be a Baltimore Oriole. I mean, the Orioles, if you ask my opinion, the Orioles are really a dumb organization. They could have traded Manny Machado, got a big old haul for him. Now they're going to wait, or maybe wait for a trade deadline to trade him. They're not going to get what they could have got right now, to be honest with you. So the Orioles, for whatever reason, think they can compete still, and they are going to sign Cobb. I don't think it'll be for 1 year because it will make absolutely no sense to sign Cobb for 1 year. If you're supposedly the Baltimore Orioles, obviously if you sign a Cobb, it'll be for like 3 years. That's how I see it. I mean, you're not going to be in contention for a few years. Obviously, I don't know what they're thinking of. Contending this year, it's just going to be a slaughter fest. The Boston Red Sox and New York Yankees are just going to destroy the AL East this season. So there you have it, folks. Yet again, this has been Felix from MMYNews.com. Share, like, and subscribe. Leave your comments below. I will read them, reply back. I will check you out, Nack. I will.